Hello and welcome to a Holy Land trip. We're going to the Holy Land today for 10 days, looking at all the different sites. Everyone's super excited because it's one thing everyone wants to do. But yeah, here we go. All right, and we just made it to Tel Aviv. We're stopped at one of the first sites. I forgot what the tour bus guy said, but yeah, we made it in. So we just came out of the Church of St. George, and it was pretty cool. There was like, it's the church where he was born, and then also the church where he's buried into. So
right now we are heading to lunch, but I just wanted to say real quick that we arrived in Tel Aviv at around like 9 o'clock or so. The current time is like 11:40. We kind of just like got out of the airport by like 10 something, and then we just went to that church. Now we're heading to lunch.
Alright, so we've arrived at our lunch location. It's kind of like right off the beach. It's like a real meat area. Alright, so we're on our first lunch at Tel Aviv. We got like pita and like a ton of different dips. Also some hummus as well. Alright, now I have my beef kebab. Also got some lemon juice and some potato fries.
I'm gonna say the lunch was pretty good food. The kebabs, really good. And same with like the hummus and stuff and all the appetizers and stuff like that. All really good food.
Right now we're visiting St. Peter's Church and St. Peter's Monastery, which St. Peter's Church is this red building and then the monastery is this white one. So we're visiting a couple of churches, but I found this really cool lookout spot. It has like a nice coastal view where you can see like really nice blue water. I don't know what sea that, I think that's the Mediterranean Sea. I could be wrong though. We have just made it to the coast area. You can see, I think that's all like Tel Aviv. And then we've made it to the ocean. You can see how nice the water looks. And I think that's like the ruins of some sort of like, I don't know, fort or something. So far, it's been.
I'm really enjoying myself.
Really enjoying yourself?
Really having a blast.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm just like super excited.
Favorite part so far of day zero, one?
Oh.
Day 0/1.
Everything, including the lunch. The lunch was amazing. I hope Jensen did all the pictures of that. I ate every single bowl I could put my little thumb into. Enjoy all the sights, and my first mass in the Holy Land was just awesome. It was in a Greek church.
Greek Orthodox church. Catholic church.
Yeah.
Which is kind of weird. I thought we only go to Roman Catholic, but now we're going to only Greek Catholic churches here. But yeah, that's really cool. The towns are all pretty cool, and the churches and the buildings. But the coolest part is like that there's so many different kinds of flowers just like hidden away. Or like, look at this massive tree. But yeah, the photographer is out at work. All right, so we came to our first hotel of the night. They actually had to change us to a different hotel because today's like the Sabbath, and our original hotel was only gonna let us in at 9 p.m. It's currently 6, so we got transferred to this hotel, and it's a 5-star hotel. But here is our room, and it is nuts. There we go. So we actually got two rooms. We got this room and that room over there, but they're actually connected. Oh, what do you mean red? Oh, what? Oh my gosh, no way, I'm locked out the room. It's not good. All right, let me try this one. It doesn't even have a door in it. Oh my gosh, I'm locked out. All right, I got an update. I got a new key. Now I'll show you. But watch. Ah, let's go, green. But look, we have one bed. Anyway, we have a bed. I think it's a queen or a king. It's really big. And then we have a really nice bathroom. Then we have a couch, a TV, a dining table, a full kitchen. And it just keeps going. And then we have another bedroom. And then if you keep going, there's another shower. My goodness. And then there's another bedroom. This is actually crazy, but that's not even the best part of the whole room. Our room, we have a balcony and you can go outside and our view is insane. We're also on the 17th floor, I should have mentioned, but look at this view. Go all the way to the edge. Look at all this. Oh my gosh. And the best part of the view is right on the beach. So we get to see all, like, the sunset. When the sun sets, we'll see it like really good. The beach as well. But look how big this balcony is. And there's chairs out here too. But like, oh my gosh, what a room. All right, we just made it a dinner. It's like a buffet kind of style, but here's my plate. It's looking like I got some stuffed chicken, some pork, some baby chicken, some like peas and carrots, rice, and some potato. But this is only course number one. All right, so for dessert, I got this dessert plus these desserts.
All right, so we just finished dinner. Food was amazing. All the different types of meats, the salads, the desserts, everything was so good. And now we're just gonna go just for a walk. Hopefully by the ocean on the sand, but yeah.
This is our hotel from the outside.
But yeah, very nice. So we'll just continue walking on this beach path. We never actually made it to the beach, but like along the coast.
But yeah, the city looks really nice and these lights and stuff. And then we always get like a view of like the cliff and then the ocean. Kind of like that. But a little different.
Okay, we're heading back to the hotel now. But very good day zero. We did way more than we had planned. It was supposed to be like a free day in Tel Aviv and we were just gonna walk around and stuff, but the tour company actually took us around, which was so much better than what we had planned originally. But yeah, tomorrow the tour officially starts. And yeah, excited to see it. All right, day zero has officially ended. And I just wanted to show the view of like the nighttime view. I know I showed the daytime, but nighttime looks quite amazing as well. With all the buildings and everything lit up and like the coast as well. But yeah, it's all darkness over there, but yeah, it's all like lit up, which is really nice and cool.
All right, so day zero is over, so we'll catch you tomorrow. Good morning. It is officially day one of our trip, and today we're gonna go right into breakfast, but I just wanted to show the morning view from our hotel. Pretty sure the sun has risen from over there. I don't want to go too close to the edge, but and then there's our view, still looking nice. It is so good to like wake up and hear like the morning waves and stuff. But yeah, I slept really good. I actually slept throughout the whole night, no issues or anything. My parents, however, they woke up at like 3 a.m. and they couldn't go back to sleep. But yeah, very good bed, enjoyed it. But time for dinner. All right, and we just made breakfast. I got some video of like the actual food, but this is my plate. I got, honestly, not sure what that is. Forgot the name, a quiche cheese something and something egg. Here's mom's plate though, and dad's.
All right, so we made our first stop of day one. We came to Caesarea Roman ruins. It's kind of where the crusaders forts were. So that's what we're going to be looking at. All right, so now we're in the theater, but this theater isn't like for like
like fighting or anything. It's more like for the nobles to like present like different plays and stuff. And yeah, it's a pretty like, I don't know, semicircle kind of thing, and then, you know, big stage. But they said that most of it was like reconstructed. Like, you see, like this rock is like actual, like looks like it's been deteriorated, but like the stone that they were like the, where the seats are, it's all like flat and smooth. So these ruins right here must be the actual part of the theater. Like what we saw before was like the renovated version. This is the ruins. It was also mentioned that like 80% of Caesarea is actually submerged underwater, because like the fort was like built weirdly. So like this is like 20% of like what's left of it that's on land. Alright, so now we made it to Pontius Pilate's palace. However, most of it is actually still underwater. Like his palace is going all the way over here, some of parts of it there as well. But yeah, this was palace as well. But yeah, I think that's pretty cool. Right over here is what they found to be a prison that was underneath the palace, which is actually St. Paul's prison. This is all still part of like Harold's castle or palace and everything. And I'm pretty sure this is like a swimming pool that he had in it, I think. Or it just could be the seawater, but still, it looks like a swimming pool and stuff. There's people fishing off it, which I think is quite funny. But yeah, but then also, right over here is where the gospel books, I think, were kept. But it just looks like a well. Right now I'm sitting on something called a toilet. It's like an outside toilet for like the nobles. Yeah. And they used to use like the sponge to for the servants to wipe, and then like to wipe their master, and then like wash it in like a running water. But that same sponge was basically used to give Jesus wine. So the tour guide says. I asked the priest about it. He says he's never heard of it. So I don't know if it's right or not, but yeah. So this is like the Pethodrome or something where the chariots used to go, but they also the tour guide also said that this is where there was like lines and lines of Christians, and they one by one they got eaten by a lion. It sounds weird, but yeah, it's like you have to confess your faith. If you don't confess your faith, you get like pulled by chains, and if you do, you get fed to the lion. These are the ruins of the crusade that happened in over the Holy Land, over here and over here. But yeah, woo, pretty cool ruins and stuff. But I'm still so surprised that 80% of all the ruins and stuff is still underwater, and they haven't even found it. So this is all we got.
Can you feel it? Now it's coming back, we can steal it. If we bridge this gap, I can see you through the curtains of the
water. So we just arrived at the Carmel Mountains. We're gonna go to a trail at the moment and then take a nice view of all the towns.
Didn't understand you were waiting as I dove into the waterfall. So say Geronimo.
So we're on top of one of the Mount Carmel mountains, and here's our view. Pretty nice. Alright, now we're on our way to lunch, I believe. So we just made it to Haifa, or Haifa, but the view is insane. I think we're actually going to lunch as well, but here's the view. Like, it's ridiculous. Like, the port, the ocean, the buildings. It's a crazy view right now. But yeah, so we're gonna have lunch right now. This restaurant right here.
Alright, so we made it to lunch. This is our starter. We got some hummus and some salad and some pita bread as well.
Alright, so our main food have arrived. My main course, I got a kebab. I got fish. I was about to say chicken. And then we got some French fries as well. Mom also has the kebab. But we have a really nice view of the port outside. For dessert, we have this and this. Not sure what either of them are. I think they're ice cream. All right, so we just came out from a 3 o'clock service, like a little mass, because apparently it's Sunday. I totally forgot it's Sunday. But yeah, we saw the church inside there, and then we saw the little church as well. But now we're going back to the bus. Right, we just arrived in Nazareth. I think we're going to, what's the church called, Mom?
Annunciation.
The Annunciation Church. I think that's right over there, yeah. The starting point, Nazareth, right here. And we're going up to the church there. So we just came out of St. Joseph's Church, which is this one right here. And there was actually like a grotto underneath the church where like you see like the actual workshop of St. Joseph, and that's where Mary and St. Joseph were. But yeah, that's actually kind of crazy. Our tour guide also said that this church is the biggest church in the Middle East, which is kind of crazy. But yeah, I think this is the basilica part. Cause you're the last of a dying breed. What are names in the wet concrete? I wonder if the therapist knows everything about me. I'm here in search of your glory. There's been a million before me that all try kind of love you. Never walk away from. You're just the last of the real ones. You're just the last of the real ones. You're just the last of the real ones. Just arrived at Magdala. We arrived at the Magdala Center, which is where we will be staying for I think the next 2 to 3 days. But yeah, apparently this place is like the good hotel in Magdala. So yeah, pretty excited. It's also right by the Galatian Sea. I feel like I said no, the Galilean Sea. Oh gosh, I don't know my information. But yeah, it should be really fun. It looked really pretty on the way down here. And it's busted. Wow. As soon as I got in, I got my free wine glass. Yeah, it looks really nice. So we just got into the Magdala Center. And this is our room.
Outside there, straight up ahead.
So you enter here. We're room number 70. Pretty nice. We got our bathroom. Oh, what a cool sink. Oh, whoa, it's stone. Wait, where's the toilet at though? Yeah. Oh, there's a separate. Oh, that's awesome. Oh wow, Pa, you can't be doing that while I'm filming. And then we got beds here. My sad little single bed. But then we got our view over here of I think that's like some mountain. He said he's like Allah Mountain. That's definitely the name of it too, so you know. But yeah, and then over there towards that side of it was actually the Galatian Sea. No, the Galilean Sea. No, the Sea of Galilee. Oh my god. I've been looking for this for so long. I've been like, I really want to see Dead Sea products because I want to see the minerals and take it back to me to the US. And in the Magdala Hotel, Dead Sea minerals! I'm actually so excited to see this or use it. But I'm definitely gonna get Dead Sea mud from the Dead Sea and bring it back to the United States, hopefully. Hopefully that I don't get caught, which could be a possibility. So we just made it to dinner. We're at the Magdala restaurant for dinner. But yeah, it's gotta be an exciting dinner for sure. But more importantly is the shower afterwards with the Dead Sea minerals. Super excited. So I got my first course. I accidentally took the wrong size plate. I got a salad plate instead of a regular size plate. Wait, here, I'll go through my plate. I got some beetroot, some couscous, some
hummus, some other kind of hummus. It's like smoother. Got some bread, some vegetables, some potatoes under, and the almighty pork. This meat, I think it's pork. What? Oh, it's beef, never mind. It's like so tender. When the chef pulled it off of the rest of the meat, it just slid off, like, oh. And then I got some sauce on top. Let's dig in this food.
Second best part of this meal just arrived.
The wine. I got my second plate now. I got some rice and beef and some, oh gosh, that's a lot of pressure. It's a priest right next to me. But yeah,
second plate.
What's that pink thing?
What? Oh, that's watermelon. All right, so for dessert, I have just four pieces of watermelon.
That's it.
That's watermelon. Watermelon. That's watermelon.
That's not watermelon.
Yeah.
No. That's
ice cream.
No.
Ice cream on a cookie or something.
Yeah. It's ice cream.
I think two glasses of wine was a little bit too much. You started to feel it a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh gosh.
But yeah, we're supposed to go to the seafront now. So hopefully. Otherwise, we might just explore around the Magdala Center area.
Just made it to the outside part of the Medjugorje Center Hotel. But yeah, so found this thing. It says Jacob's Well. Don't know who Jacob is though. But
oh, wait a minute. It's a map.
It says Galilee. Then there's a... That's a Mount Tabor, heard of that name. Oh, there's Nazareth, that's where we went today. We're gonna go to Cana tomorrow. Oh, I'm pointing the wrong place. Dang, where else is this? Oh, wait, this is where we are. Or, no, we went to Mount Carmel today as well. And we went to Haifa. Let's see, anywhere else I see. Mediterranean Sea. Oh, wait, that means we're over here. Oh yeah, Magdala. We're right here in the Magdala, right by the Sea of Galilee. I've also realized I've been saying the Sea of the Galatian Sea, but that's in Spain. But yeah, we're just, you know, checking out the outside area, trying to find the some church, some famous like photo Mom's been talking about, and then we're also gonna go visit like the actual Sea of Galilee. But yeah. So just came out of that church right there, and I did take a video of it, but like the altar was literally a giant ship with a cross on it, which I thought was pretty cool. I've never seen an altar that looked like that before. But yeah, now I just kind of just roaming around the sea. There was like a gate, so we couldn't actually go to the beach, unfortunately. But yeah, now I just kind of looking around. I can't go to the gym anymore, so well, the wind is really starting to pick up. I know you can barely hear my voice, but we found this like really cool like trees path, and there's a mountain straight ahead. But I'm pretty sure this path leads to the first synagogue. There's like a bunch of different ruins, so I'm gonna quickly check that out. And then we're gonna take a bath with the Dead Sea Minerals. So excited for that. As you enter this area, it's the synagogue where Jesus actually taught the people. And look at all the mountains and stuff. But yeah, so we're gonna walk through the synagogue where Jesus apparently taught the people. And like, there's still like the ruins and stuff here. So like, you know, it's still pretty cool. But dang, it is windy. Right, the part that I've been waiting for this entire evening, the shower. I'm gonna be using the Dead Sea Mineral Shampoo. The Dead Sea Mineral Conditioner. And then the Dead Sea Mineral Body Gel. I'm so excited. I can't contain my excitement right now. But all right, so the shower was so good. Oh. The Dead Sea Minerals was so amazing. But yeah, ooh. All right, so that means
our day number one is officially over. Wow, we did so much in day one. But my goodness, it didn't feel like it was just one day. It felt like 2 days combined into one. But yeah, so day one is over. Tomorrow we're gonna be going to Cana and some other places. And I think we're doing a boat thing on the Sea of Galilee. So that's gonna be really fun. But yeah, so good night and see you at breakfast tomorrow, or just see you tomorrow. Good morning early. Wow, this is echoing. Good morning early from the Magdala Center in Egmandela. I should have really remembered that. But it's really early in the morning. It's 6:30 in the morning today. We're gonna be going to, I think we're going to Cana today. And then we're also gonna be going to the Sea of Galilee, and we're gonna go on a boat tour too. So that's gonna be really cool. But today, since we're visiting a lot of churches and stuff, our tour guide said you can only wear long pants, but it's gonna be so hot. So I'm gonna be like burning up, but like, that's fine. But I realized also yesterday, I mispronounced this mountain here. It's actually called Mount Arbel, not whatever I said. It's pretty close though. It's both started with an A. But yeah, now we're going to breakfast. Alright, so we're at breakfast now. I got my trusty egg, some pastries, and a fig. And I got two different types of juices. Alright, so you might have been wondering where my sweets were on my first plate, but I got it on my second. I think this is baklava, and this is some sort of like apple crumble maybe? Or some apple tart. But then I got some more egg. This had like cheese in it and it tasted really, really good. And I also have another fig. All right, breakfast was really good. Now we are on our way to Cana. As my good friend Jonathan says, Cana. But but yeah, breakfast is really good. Another big meal. But yeah, ready to sweat today. So we just arrived at Cana and we're climbing this little slope thing, and we're gonna go up to the church. And I think mom and dad want to renew their wedding vows too, so pretty cool history about this place. Something about it being built in the 4th century or renovated last in the 14th century or something like that. And then now we're gonna go see the jars, or the replicas of the jars, you know, which is like located on the church. And they're like giant stone stuff. Crazy. But I heard something really fascinating about the jars. Since they're so big, Jesus actually had to go to the jars, not the jars came to Jesus. I think it's always depicted wrong in like paintings and stuff. Wine tasting. It's a pomegranate wine, I think. Pretty good. So we just finished with that Cana Wedding Church, which is really cool. I think, I honestly don't know where we're going next though. Probably another church. But I really like how all these buildings, where all the houses are all like, oh my gosh, a cat. Like all the buildings are like on the mountain. And all like the houses and stuff, they all have like flat ceiling roofs as well. I think that's something for the heat. Now we made it to the Mount of Beatitudes, but on the bus ride here, our tour guide was saying that there's another name for this place. Instead of like Israel, there's Palestine, there's Galilee, but there's also something called the Road to Chinuch, which is something in like the ancient texts where they said that this land was for like wheat, or no, for honey and milk. You know, honey from the bees, and then milk from the goats. But yeah, so that was pretty cool, knowledgeable moment. So we learned a cool word called ichthus,
which just means fish, and it's like divided up into like 8 different parts, each meeting something like Jesus Savior, the Christ or something, but like that all relates to like to this 8 parts. And then like the church here is like a octagon shape, which is 8 sides. And then the priest said something about it linking to the baptismal fonts that are like usually 8-sided like octagon things. It's kind of crazy how everything links up together. Made it to like a lookout point of like the Sea of Galilee. That's really nice. So blue as well. Yonder. And I'm pretty sure this is the same sea that Jesus walked across, right? Yeah, that's crazy. But I don't understand why it's called a sea, because it looks like it's just a lake. I'm starting to get like a burning smell. Maybe the sun is burning the grass. Still really nice view of this sea. Dad? So the Galilean Sea, right?
Mm-hmm.
Does it actually touch the seawater?
No, I think some river comes in and fills it. It's a sea,
but is it
it's a lake.
Water?
It's like a lake, I think.
Oh, okay.
But it has water coming from the sea into some.
Oh, so it is salt water.
Yeah.
We're going to St. Peter's Primacy, I think. And then we'll be able to touch the water of the Sea of Galilee there. I'm gonna go touch it. There's a sea. Holy now.
Oh, we see the same rock that is under the Jensen.
One of those fish Jesus cooked right here on this rock. That's crazy. Bigger fish. Over there. That was the actual rock that Jesus cooked the breakfast on. The one outside, it was just attached to it but broke apart from it. Now we arrived at Tabgaha. I think the multiplication miracle happened here. So we just came back to the hotel to eat our lunch, and then before we head out to a boat ride to Galilee on the Sea of Galilee. All right, so we just made it to lunch. Looks like another interesting meal we have here. So we got some rice, some chicken, some peas, different sort of salads like carrots, beetroot. Oh my gosh, Dad got the fish. The fish looks so interesting.
I have some jelly, some other white jelly. I wonder if it's called RRR.
COVID, I guess my role changed and I no longer needed a team there.
That was such a good lunch. Oh my gosh, that food was amazing. And then the dessert, oh, was actually so good. That jelly. But yeah, but now I think we're gonna be going to. I think we're gonna go to
what?
Oh, we're gonna go to the Sea of Galilee. We're gonna go on a boat tour for a little bit, and then we're gonna go to Capernaum afterwards. All right, so we just arrived at the dock for our sail on the Galilean Sea, but it is so hot right now. It's literally 104 degrees Fahrenheit. It's hot. And we're gonna go on the lake or the sea as well, which is gonna amplify the hotness. Ew. The Mount of Beatitudes and the St. Peter's Primacy. And then over there we have Capernaum. I think it's over there, which is where we're gonna be going afterwards. So we just finished with the boat ride on the Sea of Galilee. It was actually really cool. Very windy, and then we got to see all the spots that we actually went to today, and then we're seeing some spots that we're going to later on today as well, which is Capernaum. But yeah, it was really cool. The water was so blue, and the tour guide also said that it's actually a freshwater lake or sea. Yeah, freshwater sea. So I knew it, because like it doesn't even touch any parts of the actual oceans. Also on the way here, we saw like there was a truck in front of us where there was like two tanks just like on the back of it, and I was like so tempted to take a video. Okay, I did take a video and I got a couple photos, but I was like, let's go. I've always wanted to see like a tank like that in real life. Also, I heard you're not supposed to take video of it, but if you won't tell, I won't tell. Please don't tell. That means Copernicum is done. Wasn't really able to speak a lot because it was a holy place, but I got a lot of videos. Back from Capernaum to our hotel, where we're actually gonna have a we're gonna have a actual like tour around the Magdala Center. So we're gonna tour like there's like an ancient synagogue actually right by where we are. We actually toured it yesterday night. But now we're going to get a full-on explanation by our tour guide about it. I think we're also going to go visit the church as well. Then hopefully we'll go to eat some dinner. But yeah, but that's it. That's all from day number two. 2 days have passed. That's crazy. I honestly thought it was like day four or five with the amount of stuff we've done every single day. But yeah, everything's pretty good. It's also so funny, it's like when you think about how much you do in a day, it seems like your days are so long that like you're like you're thinking you're actually having like 2 days combined to one with the amount of stuff we do per day. And then but like when you're actually there in person and the tour guide says, all right, you only have 1 hour, that hour goes by within like 5 minutes, which is crazy. Like we went on a 45-minute boat ride today, and yet like I felt like it was over in like 5 minutes, and I was shocked. But yeah, it was still really fun. That this place was actually accidentally discovered when they were making the foundations for this hotel. They found these ruins. And then apparently this is a first century road that is completely untouched. However, I don't know. It looks like it's been dug a little bit, but they say that it's completely untouched. So. All right, so that concludes with our day number two. And now I'm gonna go to this map real fast and show you guys where we went today. So we started off at Magdala, right over here. Yeah, we started off there and we went to Tapgolfa. Well, first morning we actually went from Magdala all the way to Cana, and we went to the mass and tried some pomegranate sweet wine, which was really good. And then we went to Tapgolfa, and then we went to somewhere down here where we rode on the Sea of Galilee. Around here, we we went all the way up to Capernaum and went around town for 45 minutes and then we came back and then we went to Capernaum and that's where that holy town was, the foundation or the hideout or the base camp of Jesus. And then we went back to Magdala where we did just the tour of like the ruins here, or or the synagogue and stuff. But yeah, and then today is our last day at Magdala, and tomorrow I think we're going from Magdala to like the West Bank area, going to Jericho to see the wall. And then we're gonna finally head over to Jerusalem. So real quick before dinner, we actually just came to the shore of the Sea of Galilee just to check it out a little bit. And we'll head to dinner, but it's really windy. You can see the Mount Tabor. No. Right. Mount Arbel over there. All right, so now we're at dinner. And I got some rice, some chicken, some salad, some fruit, some corn, and some hummus. Got my trusty wine and some water. Right now, I have my second plate, but it's only just a salad plate. So I got my all my different types of salads, plus some hummus. Right now for the dessert, I got some watermelon, some strawberry mousse, and some chocolate and chocolate coconut dessert.
All right, and that is the end of day number two. Tomorrow we are going to West Bank, probably driving all the way to Jericho, and then finally making our way to Jerusalem. But yeah, it should be pretty interesting, especially since I think earlier today Israel just like drone struck West Bank, and now we're going to West Bank, so. Dang, it's kind of crazy, but yeah, we'll see how tomorrow goes.
Good morning from Magdala. I have woken up to see sunrise. I'm like 15 minutes early, but you can already see like the sun kind of rising from the top. Yeah, we were all supposed to wake up as a family, but I'm the only one who woke up, so I was like, I gotta do this. I gotta capture this really well. Yeah, it's gonna rise over the Sea of Galilee, so that should look really, really pretty. It honestly already is looking really pretty. It's so calm in the morning. It also looks like just like a mist. Like a mist of sun rising from the east. Alright, so sunrise looks really cool. Also, you can hear like the birds chirping in the morning and like the mist where it's coming from. It's very peaceful right now. Alright, so we've done sunset now, and then I think we're gonna just. Well, I'm gonna go back to sleep because I woke up way too early. Mom and Dad are gonna walk around, but then after that, I think we're just gonna have breakfast at like 8:30. And then like head to West Bank and Jericho and Jerusalem. But yeah, it was definitely really nice. I don't know if you could see me that whole way because I was walking against the sun, but yeah. All right, so it is officially day number three. Done with staying at the Medjugorje, the Magdala Center. So we're gonna say bye to our lovely bed with our lovely room, and we are going to Jerusalem today. So yeah, it's been a very fun experience here. All right, so we made it to breakfast again at the Magdala Center. So this is what my plates look like. I got my egg, got a pastry, another pastry, watermelons and fruit. I got some freshly squeezed orange juice as well. For my second plate, I have watermelon, I have some cookie, and I also got some cucumbers.
Right, so we just arrived on Mount Tabor. It's actually so high up. Like, you'll see the videos of us climbing. But my goodness, it's so high.
And there's a church on top of a hill. So this is the place where the transfiguration happened. And if you can see, like, the bottom stones of this church is actually the same stones from the Crusades. And then these are just, like, ruins from, like, sometime in the thousands. But, yeah, pretty crazy. The new church looks sick, though. I think it's 34 degrees Celsius, so roughly like 96, 97, something around there. It's hot, it's really hot. Now we're leaving from Mount Tabor, where the transfiguration happened. Now we are at lunch and I literally got a little bit of everything. I got my rice, all the different salads you could possibly get. I got some meat, some beef, some falafel, some pita.
Alright, so now with lunch done, we're gonna be going to Jordan River. I was about to say Jordan Lake. Jordan River, which is 2 hours away. So it's gonna be a long, long bus drive.
Alright, well, we were supposed to go to Jericho and the River Jordan today. However, we actually arrived late and they closed at 4. And we arrived around like 3:50, so like we couldn't really go explore it. So in the end, we just ended up coming to Jerusalem. But when we did get here, we got like a cool like little drink. I think I got a lemonade and a cookie. But take it away, Past Jensen. All right, so we're at the welcome drink area. I got my lemonade and I got a cookie as well. Right, now since we're done with the welcome drink, take it away, future Jensen. Hello from the future again. So now we're just gonna be exploring a little bit outside our hotel. We're probably gonna go to the holy area where the holy sepulchre and stuff is. However, we're kind of nervous because like of all the tension that's kind of happened because of what happened yesterday in Genevieve. But yeah, so we're gonna go see how it goes, but between confusion and pain, pain, pain. Distant eyes, promises we made were in vain, in vain, vain. If you must go, relic of the true cross is in that hole. Really have to make tracks. We're trying to do everything all in like the span of like 10 minutes. Try to touch every single thing here. I think this is the tomb now. This is where Jesus was laid. This rock.
is the tomb, the altar of the tomb where Jesus was laid in. So this is a 800-year-old church. Because it's been, it's been, rebuilt 3 times. And, it's literally, built into, other buildings. It's crazy. And then you see that ladder up top there. No one knows how that ladder got to be there. Or why it's still there.
This is the third version of the church. So the Franciscans have their sections over here. In the center is the big church. So when you see the big guy, that's over that main part on the other side of that wall. That's ran by the Orthodox. So they have it. And then in the middle of it is a stone that's the center of the universe for them. So all points are measured from there. So they have this central part. Everybody shares the tomb. The Coptics have the back. Different Ethiopians have places, the Syriacs, all of these things. So this is an area. All of these places, you'll see these alcoves that have different altars, and they were set, and they had different parts of the parts of the Agnes, you have the chapel of the spears, and the Longinus's chapel. You have in the Franciscan chapel over here, there's a piece of a pillar. That's the scourging pillar. So they took it. Part of it's not there anymore. Somebody wanted a piece, so they took it. Well, it turns out the ship sank in the Mediterranean, so they don't have the other part. But when you go down the stairs, you see the walls, all of the carvings, people carve their crosses from their pilgrims, they come down. The Armenians have a big section down here, and they're not notorious. They're notable for them being the first people to accept Christ. Those are the first Christians of Armenia and can be converted as a nation. And then down further, down here, is the chapel of St. Helena. So that's where they found the cross. So he died right here, he was anointed right here, he was buried right here. And they put his crosses in a hole over here. And then they covered everything up.
So we're at the Jaffa Gate right now. Alright, now we have arrived at dinner. I got a plate full of veggies and some meat that looks very tender and some rice. Alright, so second course, got some chicken schnitzel with two sorts of dips. I think one's yogurt and one's tzatziki, but I'm not 100% sure. And I have just some more salad. And then I got a jello and some wine. I'm gonna film Dad's dessert today. You got some almond cake, chocolate cake, and some chocolate pudding. Guess who lost his phone in Jerusalem? That man right there. And now we have to go. We went downstairs and they said that they gave it to the security guard. All right, but we go downstairs, I call the phone, we show them it is our phone, or my dad's phone, but they were like, okay, but show me your ID because I need to write a police report about it. So we have to go all the way back upstairs just to get the ID, even though we showed proof that that's our phone. I don't know, it's kind of weird. All right, so update, we got his phone back, but the security guard literally wrote an entire police report about what's your name? Well, how did this happen? When did this happen? About how he lost his phone. We just left it at dinner. That's it. We left it on the table. Or he left it on the table, not we. I would never do that. But he left it on the table and we left. That's all that happened. But we had to go through so much just to get the phone back. It was actually crazy. What an experience. Yeah, Israeli security is top level. All right, that's it for day number 4. Tomorrow, definitely the highlight of today was getting to, seeing the sunrise of the Sea of Galilee. And then the second one was definitely going to visit the Holy Sepulchre, the Holy Sepulchre area around Jerusalem, which was really cool how we got to see literally every single thing, except for the tomb. But since we only had 10 minutes to do it in, we did it really good and
the priest told us like so much information about it, and to just see everything was so close together, that's really crazy. But yeah, so we're gonna go to sleep now, and but like tomorrow we have an early wake up, and I think we're gonna go to Bethlehem tomorrow, which is in West Bank. But yeah, so we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna go to like some shepherd field that's near Bethlehem, where like I think the angel appeared, I'm not too sure. And then after that we're gonna go to the nativity area. But yeah, all right, good morning, it is officially day number four, I think it's day number four. And today we're going to the city of Bethlehem, but we're gonna have to go through West Bank. Yeah, and then we're gonna go to the shepherd's field as well as the nativity afterwards. Yeah, but let's start the day with some breakfast. All right, so we just arrived at breakfast, and I got a pretty big breakfast. I got some scrambled eggs, a lot of fruit. I'm not sure what that is. I think it's a quiche and donuts. All right, so we just made it to El Karim, which is the place of where I think St. John the Baptist was born. And then we're going to be walking up to like a hill where there's a church. And something about the something about rosaries is here. I forgot what the tour guide said, but yeah. All right, so I just found the church up on that hill, the one with the golden roofs, like the domes. Also, I just realized it's called In Karim, not El Karim. Someone told me the wrong information. So we just made it up to the mountain of the church, where the church is. However, it doesn't actually have the golden domes that we saw earlier. That's actually a Russian monastery. Yeah, so we made it to the church though. And look at our view from the top. Pretty nice. This is the church where, or this is the hideout that Elizabeth and John had took when King Herod was killing all the babies. And yeah, they hid him behind this rock. That one over there. And then they also built like a Crusaders church on top of it. And that's why you can see in like the paintings, there was like a Crusaders in a boat getting blessing by like the Pope or something. A big shout out to our tour guide David. He literally knows everything. He's got like 2 master's degrees as well. And he's so knowledgeable on everything. That's crazy. And I'm like information overload up here because he's like recites everything off so fast, and I'm like, whoa, what's going on? But yeah, pretty good trip so far. All right, we just arrived in Palestine. Yeah, we're at like Bethlehem, I think, and we're not really allowed to take a lot of videos or photos, but there's like a separation wall that separates like Bethlehem area, and like they can't actually like get out of the wall, which is really crazy. All right, so we just made it to our Palestinian restaurant. We got our starters out already. All right, I got my salad and my pita bread and my hummus as well. Now for dessert, we got some sort of baklava, I think. Can you feel it? Now it's coming back. We can steal it. If we bridge this gap, I can see you through the curtains of the waterfall. When I lost it, yeah, you held my hand, but I tossed it. Didn't understand you were waiting as I dove into the waterfall. So say Geronimo, say Geronimo, say Geronimo, say Geronimo, say Geronimo, say Geronimo, say Geronimo.
We just finished lunch, and now we're gonna be exploring like the shepherd's field around the town of Bethlehem, where the shepherds were.
So I just heard a really interesting fact. Jesus wasn't actually born in a manger. He was born in a cave, because they didn't have like wooden mangers back in the day. They only had caves. And his crib
was like made out of stones, not like a hay or anything like that, which is really interesting because I never knew that before. And also shepherds used to live in caves. Didn't know that either.
The fields that the shepherds were,
they're kind of like this. They're kind of like, you know, not super grassy like I thought it would be. But yeah, that's kind of what it is. It's like the field of a shepherd.
I just learned that the king's men took 2 years to get to the manger, the cave, instead of 3 days, what you would be told. But yeah, like, it's crazy. Like, it took them 2 years because they were so far away. And then their names of their... The names that we gave them is equivalent to the name in Persian of what their gift was, which is also something I had no idea about. And then, yeah. So much information.
It's the cave where he was born. Where Jesus was born. This is the manger. AKA the cave.
The star marks Jesus' place of birth.
That's where Jesus was born. His place of birth. This is the manger. The North Star. Wait, are we trapped? There's no way.
Oh my gosh.
It is cool here too. Stairs from the main church into like this grotto-ish area, which we thought there was gonna be a way out, but there's no way out. So now we're kind of just all standing in one tiny little room.
So we just went down and I touched the spot where Jesus was born and was put in a manger, which is really cool. And then that area that I thought we got trapped in, that area we actually said our mass in there, which was pretty cool to be almost right by where Jesus was born to have mass.
And now we're just outside. I think we're going back to the bus and then potentially going to dinner. I don't know. I'm not sure what we're going to be doing after this though. But so far it's been crazy of a day. So much history that I've never known before, which is insane too. Apparently when the Crusaders came, they drew on the pillars because they didn't have really anything to like destroy of the church. And, like, this church, nothing of it has been completely destroyed since it was built, which is crazy. So that means this is a really, really old church. And then all of this paintings or the mosaics on the walls used to cover the entire wall. However, like, parts of it fell off and they couldn't restore everything, so. Like, there's just like bits and pieces of it left now. But this is also like the church where you can go down like 14 steps and then see where Jesus was born and the manger he was in, which is really cool. And then 14 steps because like in Hebrew, like they do their numbers with letters. And if you spell out David in numbers in Hebrew, you get 14 and then they got 14 steps. So that's a bit of history about this church.
I find it hard to say the things I want to say the most. Find a little bit of steady as I get close. Find a balance in the middle of the chaos.
semi-lost, semi-high, semi-never, demigod. I remember walking in the cold of November, hoping that I'd make it to the end of December. 27 years in the end of my mind, but holding to the thought of another time. But looking through the ways of the ones before me, looking for the path of the young and lonely. I don't wanna hear about what to do, I don't wanna do it just to do it for you. Hello, hello, let me tell you what it's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to always feel, feel like I'm empty and there's nothing really real, real. I'm looking for a way out. Hello, hello, let me tell you what it's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to never feel, feel like I'm good enough.
Alright, so we have just come back to the hotel from our Palestine trip. Yeah, everything was really, really cool. All the churches, we saw the place where Jesus was born, the manger, the shepherd's cave, and the field that they saw as well, or in they tailed with their flocks of sheep and stuff. That was all really, really cool. Yeah, now we're gonna go eat some food for dinner. All right, so we just arrived at dinner. My plate is, I think I got veal shoulder, some sushi, a Moroccan cigar, some sort of meat thing. I don't know what it is. It's over there, and I just got some more salad and some hummus. Got my water and my wine. Now it's time for some dessert. I got some watermelon, some like chocolate sponge kind of cake. This thing, I have no idea what it is. I think that's baklava, and I don't know what that one is, but then there I've got some carrots. And finally, our last course, more dessert. I got strawberry and mango sorbet. Still working on my wine though. We finished our bottle.
All right, so that concludes day number 5 of our trip. It was a really, really, really cool trip. Day today, I learned so much about like Jesus, with the how he was born and like where he was born and like the shepherds and stuff, because I didn't realize it all happened in caves and like just modern day. We always just think it's like in the stable with like animals and stuff, and like in a nice like hay manger or whatever. So it was so cool to learn how it's all about like in caves and stuff. And then so yeah, that's it for today. But tomorrow we're going to be going to all like the different mountains. So we're going to like Mount Olive and some other mountain. I forgot the name of it, but Mount Spine. Oh, Mount Zion. Oh, whoops. But yeah, catch you guys tomorrow.
Good morning. It is day number 6. Today we are going to go to the Olive Mountain and Mount... What's the other mountain?
Zion.
Yeah, we're having another, I think this is our 3rd early start in a row. We've been waking up at 6 a.m. To like leave by like, I think 7:45. So then we have our breakfast at 7 and stuff. But yeah, let's go to breakfast.
Good morning, we're at breakfast right now.
I got my plate of my sunny side egg on toast, something called a cheese burkies. I got some fruit.
Dad has a stacked plate.
Got some water and orange juice.
We just arrived at Mount Olive, and you see all these writings on the walls. It's like, it's literally the Our Father in like a ton of different languages. I think it's like 170 all around. But yeah, this is the church. This part of the church, like all these arches and stuff, was built during the crusading period. Yeah, the crusaders built all that part, and now we're gonna go visit the church so we can find the English version of the Our Father.
Olives is the birthplace of the Our Father. That's why there was like 170 country languages with the Our Father around the entire area. So pretty crazy. It was like the password to get into this area too. Each rabbi had one, so that was pretty cool. I had a little mistake in my last video. I said that was the first place. It was actually the second place that the Our Father was said. First place was in the Sea of Galilee.
Now we got a little overview look of the Old Jerusalem. You can see like the city walls. I think that is where the upper room and the lower room is.
in Mount, I think it's called Cyprus. Probably messed that up. And then we see this this golden building right there. That's the Dome of the Rock. Also the, it's like the Muslim mosque. I forgot the other name for it. But yeah, this is a really nice overview. We're kind of in like this like cemetery area, and it costs $1 million just to have one tomb. And as you keep going down, the price actually goes higher and higher. But yeah, we're still on the Mount of Olives. As you can see, there's some olive trees up here. And I think we're going further down. So we're currently walking on the Palm Sunday Road, or the Palm Road. So like, palms actually came from Jericho, and the people in Jerusalem who don't have palms, they actually just use like olive branches from the olive tree to wave it around. So we're still on the Mount of Olives, and our tour guide said like the Jerusalem we have today is like really, really small. It's like, he said it's back in the day, Jerusalem would have been like 10 times bigger, I think he said, than what it has been today. So in this like valley area is where Abraham met with Melchizedek face to face for the very first time. And that wall right there, that's the only gate that is closed, and is closed by the Ottomans during the Ottoman Empire. And then also apparently like the walls of how it is today is how the Crusaders made the walls. When, back in Jesus' day, like the Holy Sepulcher was outside the walls. I think that was the Church of Zion. It was also outside, but like it was all in a different.
We're about to go into this church, and it's supposed to be like a really mourning, sad church, because like everything is like dark, and like all like the lights from the windows as well, it's like limited the amount of light that can go in, and everything's like black and purple. We just finished mass, which was really cool. Now we're in the Garden of Gethsemane with all the olive trees. You can see how big these trunks are. They're like 1,000 to 2,000 to 4,000 years old. It's actually crazy. Like, look at that. Look at the size of that trunk. So Gethsemane means Gashemen, which means pressed oil or first oil. So this is where they tested it. And this is like first century oil is here. All olive oil. I can't remember. It's been after the mass of what that we said in the where the agony rock is, and I can't remember what David said, but yeah, that's I think that's what he said. But it's definitely Gashemen, which is like press oil.
Let me tell you about it. Well, let me tell you about it. Say the truth will set you free. Hello, hello, let me tell you what it's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to always feel, feel like I'm empty and there's nothing really real, real. I'm looking for a way out. Hello, hello, let me tell you what it's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to never feel, feel like I'm good enough for anything that's real, real. I'm looking for a way.
So this writing up here says you couldn't stay with me for 1 hour. Alright, so I just made it to lunch. I got some rice, some chicken, some pasta, a lot of the salad, some hummus as well.
So for the main course, we go into our desserts.
To Mount Zion and see the church all the way up top there. So we just visited King David's tomb. However, it was like in the synagogue, and it was like divided, like half of the tomb was divided between men and women. It was really weird, but kind of cool at the same time. But so we're at this church right here, and apparently this church is built upon John the Apostle's house.
So like a first century house is like underneath all of this church. And this church was also built upon the Byzantine and the Crusaders period as well.
All right, so this area is where the fake trial of Jesus happened. It was only fake because it was nighttime when the trial was happening, and you weren't actually allowed to have trials at night, so they called it the fake trial.
But yeah, this is also like the courtyard, I think, where Peter denied Jesus 3 times, and then the cock crowed.
So apparently there wasn't actually a real cock that that crowed. It was a Roman horn called Calicantu that rings... Yeah, that sounds like when it's blown, sounds like a cock crowing, which is something I never knew. I always thought it was a real chicken, but guess it wasn't. So we technically ended our day early because tomorrow we're going to be waking up super early to do a ton of stuff. I think our wake-up call is at like 5 a.m. and we're leaving the hotel at like 6:15. But today we're going to take our off day or off evening and go walk around the old city of Jerusalem. I got some saffron bread, so we'll try it out right now. Can I just say it's like sweet bread? It's really hard though.
Alright, so this is called the original bagel. This is before the bagel, and it's like a giant, like oval-shaped, piece of bread.
Mmm, pretty good.
Got another piece of the saffron bread, but this one actually has a piece of date in it, so. And they say that it's actually the better part of the bread. It's nice and soft.
We arrived at the Holy Sepulcher.
Wow, that's crazy. We came in from that entrance last time. This time we came in from like the Muslim quarters. We went from the, I think the Christian quarters last time. Excuse me, I got the bread still in my mouth. But yeah, here's the Holy Sepulcher.
So we were walking with the priests and all our other group. And mom and dad, they went into a store to get some spices. And they taste pretty good, but while doing so, we kind of lost our entire group.
So now we're just wandering through the old city, trying to find our way back to the hotel.
Dinner is at
7 at the hotel, at 6:26. Hopefully we make it back.
All right, a bit of an update. We found our group. Luckily, they're all right there. Oh my gosh. Can't believe that. So we just made it back to the hotel.
And look at the time. Boom!
7:01. Right in time for dinner, which is at 7. So, perfect.
Alright, so we made it to dinner now. I am currently at the table, holding the spots for everyone. But, yeah, time to pour me some wine. My rice, chicken. I got some chicken shawarma as well over there. I got some salads. And I got a beef bowl. I got my wine, and I also have my water as well. For dessert, we got 3 macaroons. I'm trying the Israeli macaroons. I'm not sure how it will compare to my macaroons. I definitely think my macaroons are way better, 100%.
Holding it in for a while.
come to Adam's Apple. No, Adam's Chapel. Adam's Chapel. Where the rocks split.
Take it in, but don't look down. I'm on top of the world, eh?
Alright, and that concludes day number 6 with our Jerusalem trip. Today was so fun, or fun, but, you know, kind of sad. It was more of a saddish day because we visited a lot of, like, places that, like, were a little bit more, like heartfelt or, like, kind of sad. Like, we visited the Rock of Agony and the Garden of Gethsemane and, like, the area where Peter denied Jesus 3 times, and like also where Jesus was like put in like this pit in the ground. So like it was kind of a sad day, but also we did so much, and towards the end of the day it like kind of got better because like we went to like the Holy Sepulchre again, which was cool for the second time that we went there, and we could go and like put our hand back in the hole of where the cross was. But this time we actually went to the church of Helena, Queen Helena. She was the one who like found like all of, like the cross artifacts like where the Holy Sepulchre was. So that is like really cool to like, you know, see that and everything. But yeah, overall today was really fun. And tomorrow is gonna be a long day for sure. Like tomorrow we have to wake up at like 5 in the morning, and then we're leaving from the hotel at 6:15. So it's gonna be long and tiring day, but like we only have 2 days left and we've done almost every single thing to do in Jerusalem so far. So yeah, good night. Also, I forgot to mention the church that we went to yesterday was actually the Saint Jerome's like area, like place where he actually like translated the Bible. I'm not sure if I mentioned this yesterday, but I just wanted to make sure I put it in today for tomorrow's or yesterday's video, you know. Morning, the current time is 5:43, and we are all awake, and we have to head to the bus at 6:15 to go to do the Way of the Cross by towards the Holy Sepulchre. So we'll do that before breakfast, and then we'll come back, eat breakfast, and then go back out. And then I think we're going back to the Holy Sepulchre to get a full in-depth tour about the whole thing.
So we have arrived at our gate where we're gonna start our Way of the Cross. So this is like a mini model of what Jerusalem looked back in the day. And right over here is where we are. We're at the place where Jesus' trial happened. And this is also the place where he got like placed with the crown of thorns here as well. So. Right, so I wasn't actually able to film inside the tomb, but I can just really quickly describe to you what I saw when we first enter it. And there's like a small chapel about like the angel, and there's like a stone in the middle. And then once you go through there, then you actually get to the actual tomb itself. There's like a slab of marble or stone right there. And then behind it is like all golden, like, all like golden, I don't know, sculptures of like Jesus and stuff. So it was really cool. It was really dimly lit, but I wasn't allowed to take any like footage of it. Yeah, I gotta mention this whilst we were doing the walk, was, you know, the Way of the Cross. But so Jesus was he had only the horizontal part of the cross. The vertical part was already at Calvary, so he had to walk with it like on his arms like this all the way, and it was just a horizontal piece of wood, which I never knew before. I always thought it was like both, like the whole thing that he'd have to carry all the way, but it's just a horizontal piece. So I got my breakfast. It's more of a simple breakfast today, but yeah, still pretty cool. This is the original bagel with some cheese, some hummus, and some sort of meat.
This is Herod's Antipas's palace, right on, I believe this is also Jaffa Gate as well.
Jaffa Gate. Says it right up there.
It's actually disconnected to the walls, which I'm kind of surprised about.
So this church belongs to France. That's where the French flag is up. It's a sovereign territory, I think. This is also the place, the birthplace of the Virgin Mary, I think.
Church is a church from the Crusaded period, and they said that it's like one of the only churches that hasn't been like renovated or restored. It's like in its original form.
So we're at the Wailing Wall right now, and it's just this tiny stretch of it, and men get like 3/4 of the wall, but women only get like a fourth of the wall. It's like divides between men and women. They say that it's called the Wailing Wall because people like cry and get very emotional with their intentions as they put it to the wall. But yeah, some history about the wall is that it was like part of like, I think it was Harold's temple that he built. Kind of part of it. Like the foundations was a part of it. And then like when the priests and the Shekinah of the Harold's temple, like they say that they've left throughout the Western Gate, or the Western Wall. So when they found the foundations of the wall, they built another wall on top, and then they thought they would be closer to God if they like put their prayers here. So that's how we got our Western Wall today. Entering the old city now through the east gate. So we just made it to lunch at Casanova. It's actually a hotel in the city of, like, around, like, the old city of Jerusalem, which is pretty cool. But here's my plate. Got my different salads, plus my hummus, some pasta, some fish, and some more vegetables. And then there's no meat today because it's Friday.
And here we have a papa sleeping after he has devoured his lunch.
I just wanted to say real quick, so this is the third time going into the Holy Sepulchre and putting my hand in the hole, but our tour guide said that the stone in the side that is like, so the hole that you put your hand in, it's like stone marble, but it's like on top of another stone that touches the stone of where Jesus was crucified. It's not the actual hole, but it's basically connected to the hole itself. So I just wanted to put that out there because I didn't know that, and then I just found that out today. And then also the stone tablet that Jesus was laid on that I showed before in my vlog, that stone marble is attached to another stone, which is attached to another stone, which is like a couple feet down below, which is the same stone that Jesus did get laid on. So it's like all connected, but they're not the exact thing. And then lastly, I always hear about like the place of the skull, the place of the skull. I didn't really know what that means, but now I just found out that it's like the place of the skull means like the place of the skull is like Adam's skull was like buried beneath where Jesus was
crucified, and then when he crucified, like, the earth cracked, and then we got to see Adam's skull. I'm sorry for the loud sound. It's like the construction or repairs that is coming from, like, the Holy Sepulchre area, so, yeah.
I just got in trouble with one of the priests here, because I was sitting with my legs crossed like this, and he said, he came up to me, and he was like, no, 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 you can't be doing that here. You can sit down, but you just can't cross your legs. And I was like, oh, I didn't know. You have to keep your legs nice and straight the whole time. That's crazy.
The thing that I learned was that in Pontius Pilate's years, his 10 years of, like, being emperor or being ruler, he never ever crucified anyone. And he only crucified Jesus and two other people because he got peer pressured into doing it. And since he got peer pressured, he chose the spot. Usually the crucifixions from the previous ruler happened on Mount Olive, but Pontius Pilate picked Golgotha instead, which is...
All right, so we bought some sort of coated nuts. And what's in this one?
Oh, just some regular nuts. So we got some coated nuts as well. I'm gonna try one right now. All right, I'm gonna try one of the coated nuts.
Really good.
All right, so that concludes our spent time in the old city of Jerusalem. I don't think tomorrow we're going there. So yeah, for the past 2 days, I think we've just been walking around here, which is all really cool and stuff, and learning about all that history. But yeah, tomorrow we're definitely gonna be going to the Dead Sea finally, and Jericho, and I think the River Jordan as well. But yeah. This is farewell to the old city. Bye-bye. All right, so now we've come back to the hotel, and we got some sweets yesterday from the marketplace of the old city of Jerusalem. We got some Jerusalem delights, even though they're kind of like just regular Turkish delights. But here's our little... we got this one. This one, I'm kind of... I think it's going to be pistachio-y. This one looks like kind of like... I don't know, nuts. Oh no, not nuts. These are like oats on it with some sort of like powder. This one I think has like nougat. This one looks really interesting too. Looks like it's like kind of squishy too. Yeah, these are the same, and then this one's the same as the other one. But yeah. Oh wait, actually no, it's different. It's the same like white coating, but like there's like nuts on this one. But yeah. We're about to try them, and I'm super excited to try the these, like, you know, Jerusalem delights. All right, so now I'm gonna try the pistachio Jerusalem delight. I think there's like nougat in the middle, and then it's like this green little thing around it. But yeah, let's try it. Mmm, it's really good. It's like candy on the outside, and then like nougat in the middle. Onto our second piece of Jerusalem delight. This one actually just looks like a regular piece of Turkish delight. You know, just kind of sugar coated square block of jelly. But yeah, let's try it. Boy, I know now why it says Jerusalem delight, not Turkish delight. It has this weird spice in it, but it tastes like it smells like Israel. That makes any sense at all. But yeah, it's weird. All right, so now Mama and I are just kind of just walk the streets of Jerusalem a little bit. We're on a mission to get some water. And maybe some weird, like local, like kind of like chocolate bars or like sweets. So that's kind of what we're up to right now. And I do want to mention that we're walking based upon our past walks to the old city of Jerusalem. So we might actually get lost, but hopefully we don't. All right, we were walking and Mom took the wrong turn. She went that way.
And then she was like, started walking, and I was like, Mom, I don't think this is the right way. I think we followed the tram line. And she was like, oh yeah, we did. Oh my gosh. Sense of direction, not good on my, definitely not good. My goodness. We would have gone to goodness knows where. And now we've decided just to like head back the way we came because we don't know where we are. All right. And now we have finally come back to the Newgate-ish area. Yeah, we went from Jaffa, or from our hotel to Newgate, in the city to Jaffa Gate, back into the city to Newgate, and now we're heading home. But yeah. All right, so we're on our way back, and we took like a too early of a turn that we took originally, and now we're just like walking through this part. But like, I know exactly where we are, but Mom has no idea. She thinks we're lost, but little does she know is we're walking on the way we came back from the Damascus Gate, which is literally a straight path straight to the hotel. Right, so we just came back from our walk, and this is our haul. We got water, we got this chip packet, which is literally all in a different language, so I really don't know what to expect. And then I got this chocolate wafer. Woo! All right, now we're at dinner. I got some new type of meat. I got actually duck and something called asado. Don't know what that is, but duck is roasted duck, some rice and some salad. Got my wine and I got my water as well. All right, now time for some dessert. I got this, this kind of cake. Not sure what flavor it is gonna be. I think it might be strawberry. And I got this pistachio looking cake as well. And this lemon looking cake. And some chocolate looking cake. Now, after dinner, we decided to go for a quick little stroll around the block of Israel. But you know, I kind of went a bit overboard because I was like, oh, my second last day in Israel. Gotta enjoy the Israeli wine as much as possible. So I had three glasses and now my head's a little bit, you know, but we're walking. Yeah, see how this night walk goes. Walk down the streets, right? And we see that no one else is around walking. And then somebody got scared, so we're making a beeline right back to the hotel. But yeah, no one at all. Motorbikes are driving, zooming down the road. Same with cars, they're just like going. But like, it's crazy how people drive, you know. But yeah, and anyways, we're going back home, back to the hotel. All right, so we came back to our room after our walk, and we're gonna be trying this. I don't know, it's everything is in a different language. I took one sniff and I was like, smells like peanut butter. But let's give it a try. It's like a cheese puff, except no cheese, with peanut butter of a flavor. So it actually is peanut butter. I actually kind of like it though. It's pretty good. All right, and now we are gonna try this chocolate looking like wafer covered in chocolate. Right now I've unwrapped the bar and I'm gonna take a bite out of this. This looks really good. So I can't wait to try it. Mmm, it's actually really good. As you can see, there's layers. Mmm. It's really chocolatey though, but it's really good at the same time, so. All right, that concludes day number 7. Tomorrow is day number 8, which is our last day here. So this was our penultimate day in Israel. But yeah, today was really fun. We first in the morning we went to the tomb of Jesus and like his resurrection place as well, and it was pretty good in the morning because there wasn't that big of a line, so we got in pretty good. And then we had Holy Mass in the Holy Sepulchre in one of the chapels, which I was like, okay, that's really cool.
to have mass said in the Holy Sepulchre. Pretty cool. And then after that, we went to like the Western Wall and the Wailing Wall. We saw all that and like where the temple was, and you know. We also did the Way of the Cross in the morning too. Totally forgot about that. That was also really cool to like walk the actual footsteps where Jesus like walked throughout the city of Jerusalem. But yeah, overall it was a really fun day in Jerusalem. Sad that our trip is actually ending, but tomorrow is gonna be a fun day for sure. We're gonna go to we're gonna meet the Patriarch of Jerusalem, which is actually crazy that you're meeting someone higher than a bishop and higher than an archbishop. We're meeting the Patriarch, which is gonna be cool. And then we're finally gonna go to the Dead Sea! I've been waiting all trip for this, so I'm pretty stoked for it. And then we're also gonna go to Jericho as well. But yeah. All right, good morning. It is our last day in Israel, in Jerusalem, in the Holy Land. Today we're going to the Dead Sea. So excited. And also going to Jericho. And hopefully we're riding camels there too. Can't wait. It's been so long since I've ridden a camel. I think the last time was in Kuwait, which was so many years ago. It was like 2006, I think we went. So, so really excited for that. But, and then in the morning, we're going to be meeting the Patriarch of Jerusalem, which is there's a bishop, but then there's an archbishop, and then there's the patriarch. And so, we're meeting a really, really high up priest, basically, which is kind of crazy. But let's first get the day started with some breakfast. All right, so we just made it to breakfast, and I got something. It was under a heat lamp. I don't know what it is. It's like some sort of bread. Then I got this. I think it's some cheesy thing inside. And then I got a pastry, and I got 3 watermelons.
Now we're at the Latin Patriarchy Church, and this is actually a cathedral to the church in Rome. So basically, it is the second highest seat for the Pope. So when the Pope comes to Jerusalem, he comes here to this area. And the church was beautiful, may I add.
I think this is the second seat right here.
We just finished our meeting with the Patriarch, which was really sick. But I think I'm gonna claim this, that I'm the only person in the world to meet the Patriarch in Jerusalem who is wearing a minion shirt. Wait, let me see if I can show my back. That's me wearing a minion shirt. Literally, look.
Minions.
See? So I'm gonna claim that. Only person in the world to do that, which is kind of crazy, but also at the same time, I wore the shirt thinking that we were going to the Dead Sea area and stuff, and I didn't really think that put it in my mind that we were gonna meet the Patriarch, but still gonna claim it.
Had mass in the Cathedral,
which is amazing. And then I think now we're on towards to Bethany.
I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way out. I kept on falling short of something.
So we just arrived in Bethany, and this is the place where Lazarus was raised from the dead. So, and I think we're gonna visit a church here as well. We just went inside the Lazarus church, and it was really cool because there was no windows on the side to make it seem more of a tomb of Lazarus and where he got raised. It was really cool, and the only light source was from the top. There was in the middle of the dome, there was some light there, but
the side, like even you can see here, there's just like no windows on the side of the church. But yeah, besides that, it was really cool. All right, so we just made it to the River Jordan, or the Jordan River. And yeah, so we're about to go and see it, but I just wanted to say that, like, if you look on the horizon, you see those buildings over there? That's actually part of Jordan, and the Jordan River is like basically borderline West Bank and Jordan. At the River Jordan, it's not what I expected it to be. I thought it would be like blue water gushing down, but now it's just kind of like muddy and murky. But yeah, on the other side is Jordan, and yeah, we're in West Bank. But yeah, pretty cool. There's a lot of like palm trees around. And all these palm trees, ooh, it's hard to see, but they have like dates falling off of them. I never knew palm trees made dates or bore fruit of grapes, but yeah, pretty cool. No, not grapes, dates. Oh my goodness. Now we're in Jericho. And Jericho is apparently the oldest city in the world, which is crazy. We went to this really cool like glass shop, but now I think we're gonna be heading to, heading to the Dead Sea, where we're gonna have lunch, and then we're gonna jump into the water and see if we can float. So from this location, we can actually see the Mount of Temptation, which is right over yonder. Right, so we're actually not gonna be like viewing the like going up to Mount Temptation, because I'm pretty sure the mountain is kind of closed. But here we're at like a viewing site. This is like a hotelish area, I think, but like the churches and stuff is over there. Yeah. We're finally here. We're at lunch, but also more importantly, the Dead Sea. All right. So now for our starters, I got some hummus and some salad and my pita bread and some water. My starters actually kind of just got mixed in with my main, but now I got rice and some beef. I think it's falafel. Or kebab. Right, so we're about to go to the lowest part on Earth, which is -413 meters. To the Dead Sea we go! I won't be able to film anything though, because I can't take my phone. But yeah, so we'll see how it goes. Alright, so we made it to the Dead Sea. Here's the Dead Sea. So that means Operation Mud is a go. Right, so we just came back from the Dead Sea, and oh my gosh, the experience was amazing. Like, you would just, like, effortlessly, like, float. It was really cool. And the best part is, Operation Mud was a successful. I got my whole mud jar as my souvenir. So, pretty excited about that. But, yeah, it was so cool. Salt water actually did go in my eyes, but, like, it was fine in the end. But, pretty cool experience. Unreal. And definitely good to try it once in my life. All right, so we just made it back to the hotel after the Dead Sea, and whoo, the Dead Sea was so good. I was just like floating and floating, but I got my mud. But now, well, I mean, like 30 minutes or so, we're gonna go back to the old city and just take like a walk around. But we got some chocolates from what was it? I think it was like from the River Jordan area. There was like a gift shop. We got some chocolate, so we're gonna try this Milka wafer cookie. All right, so I just unwrapped the Milka wafer. It looks kind of like this, but yeah, let's give it a try. Mmm, that's really good. So we decided to go out and have one last walk in Jerusalem before we leave tomorrow. So we're just gonna be walking down the main road, I think probably to Newgate, then go to Jaffa Gate, maybe go to the Holy Sepulchre, and then probably try find Damascus Gate, but
I know, we'll see how it goes.
All right, so we made it to the Holy Sepulchre. And guess what we did again? Yep, we put our hand back into the hole where Jesus was crucified. And we touched the tablet as well. But yeah, that's the last time. Five times the charm, that's what they say, right? This is our last time at the Holy Sepulchre. Not sure if I will ever be back. Hopefully maybe one day I'm back here. But yeah, such a cool experience we had in Jerusalem and even in Israel of this whole entire trip. But yeah, and we went to Palestine too in the West Bank, which is crazy. And then we basically looked at Jordan over the river. But yeah, it was such a cool trip. I really learned so much from this trip as well. As our walk is coming to an end, we're saying bye-bye to the city of Jerusalem for the last time. Bye-bye to the Jerusalem sun. Bye-bye to the old city. Oh wait, you can't see that, but yeah. Yeah, but we're heading over to dinner.
All right, so now we're at dinner. This is our final dinner. Got my wine, my water, but I also got a gift. I got a bag. In my bag, I have a little chain. Then I have then I have like a bracelet that I got. I got a nativity set as well. And then I got the good stuff. I got the thank you. Oh, I got a certificate too. I got Dead Sea Salts, and I got a hand cream as well. Pretty good. All right, so now I got my food. I decided to be a little adventurous today, and I got some beef tongue. I got some... I got some potatoes, some beef, like meatball kind of things, and like a beef galoche. And I also have a salad on the side and my wine and water.
All right, so we just came back from dinner. We packed up all of our suitcases. We're ready to go for our flight tomorrow morning. But I just wanted to say, I did not like that beef tongue. It was too meaty and it just had this weird taste in my mouth. And right before I ate it for the first time, like I was eating it, like all my other meats on my plate, and then I was about to eat the tongue, and I didn't even think about it being tongue. And then the guy next to me was like, and then someone said like, oh, have you tried the tongue yet? And then I was like, no, I was about to try it. And then it was like kind of in my mind, so I tried it, and then I was like, ooh, it's tongue, and I didn't like it. So I think it was psychologically, like, you know, in my mind that I wouldn't like the tongue, but like, you know, it's fine. I tried it, only gonna try it once, so it's fine. I just wanted to say the reason why we got to meet him was our priest that came on our pilgrimage with us. He's actually part of the Knights of the Sepulchre. So he's a knight there, so he got a pin for his like pilgrimages and stuff of a shell. So, and the patriarch actually gave it to him. So we got to just sit in the room while I was watching him, and we got to ask questions to him. So that was so cool. And I was like, dang, that's so cool. We meet the patriarch, which is like pretty close to like the Pope, but like not the Pope. But yeah, we sat in the same room as him, and I was like, oh my gosh. But yeah, really, really cool. And I really enjoyed this experience of the Holy Land. I'll catch you in the morning when we'll have to leave.
All right, so we are leaving Israel. It was a very good trip. The Holy Land was amazing. I hope I will come back one day again, but yep, see ya.